safety, that laparoscopic insufflator is the most important instrument. Because most of the complication happens due to the wrong technique of insufflation, which is invisible. If your camera is not good, you can see on the monitor my image is not coming good. If your telescope is not good, you can make out. If your harmonic ligation is not working, you can see that, oh no, it's not cooking. But insufflator, pressure we cannot see by eye, and gas also we cannot see. So most important safety concern happens due to the wrong understanding of insufflator. And insufflator is the most poorly understood instrument. Generally, what we think about insufflator is something which is just pumping the gas, but it is the most intelligent instrument in the laparoscopy, all the electronics. Once you have an insufflator, you have different type of insufflator. Like some of the insufflators are analog insufflator. That one is analog insufflator. This is a star insufflator which was present at one time. Now almost stopped. This is laparoflator with the Quadro Manometric indicator, four indicators. It doesn't have any electronic circuit. It is completely working on the pressure of the gas cylinder. It has also safety devices to cut and start, but it is now almost stopped. The company has stopped making it. Now after that, this is digital insufflator. They will say you, we have 6 liter, then we have 118 liter, we have 130 liter, we have 145 liter. Then you will ask that price. Then they will say that 6 liter will cost you only 50,000. Suppose you are beginner, and still right now you will not go for bariatric or colorectal or splenectomy. Your career is as a gynecologist, diagnostic tubal patency test, simple procedures you want to do. Then in those situations, 6 liter insufflator means it cannot push the gas more than 6 liters per minute. But suppose you want to perform the advanced procedure like bariatric, colorectal, solid organ, you need 45 liter insufflator. Because solid organ surgery, sometimes there is a possibility of massive bleeding, like renal arteries rupture, splenic arteries puncture. Then you have to use suction. And sometimes 10 mm suction is also required, and you are sucking fast. Sometimes with the 10 mm suction, the suction of the gas exit may be 30 liter per minute. So if it is 30 liter per minute you are sucking, you are not only sucking the blood, gas also you are sucking. And your insufflator is only 6 liter, abdomen will collapse. And once the abdomen will collapse, your vision is lost. Abdomen will collapse, telescope will touch the Mishra. Vision is lost, you cannot do anything. But if you have a high capacity insufflator, you don't have a problem. You are sucking, but still abdomen is disturbed. You have the syringe, you will do irrigation, suction, hanging drop test. And then suppose I am attaching it like this. I have attached the tubing with the variation. And then I am selecting, then I am attaching, and then it is switched on. Once you will switch it on, testing the device. Device is tested, and after testing the device, it will do the check. It will check the cylinder and is writing device OK. So device is checked, then device OK. This is fine. Now again it is going. I am selecting one of the mode, and I have selected suppose this mode. Then it is everything is fine, but it is giving a cross. That is cross, and it will write here RTP deactivated. You will see mode high, and this is crossed. And when I will touch it, RTP deactivated. What is this? This is an alarm, this is an error. Relay transport protocol is deactivated. And it is making a valve check here, and it is crossing red color. If I will try, it will not start. It will write RTP deactivated. What does it mean? That this insufflator understood that this surgery is not good. So I should not obey his command. Why? Because you saw what I did, the mistake. I have attached the tubing first and then I switch on the insufflator. If your nurse is attaching the IV cannula first, after that she will attach the IV set, and then she will attach the IV set in the IV bottle, what will happen? Air will enter, and there may be air input. So this is wrong. So what you should do? First you should switch on the insufflator. So I am switching it off, this power, and again switching it on. And keep the tip of this insufflator open. And a lot of gas will come out through the tubing of the insufflator. And the insufflator will completely release the trapped gas. It is a microprocessor which is doing it. And amount of gas from the tip of the insufflator up to the cylinder is 800 ml. And all these 800 ml is out. And after that, you will not see any air. It is giving you okay. Okay, sir. Okay, sir means now it is okay. Insufflator is happy with you. And after that, you will for long press, like 3 seconds. Then it will allow you. It goes 16, 17, 18. 18 or 20 is used for extra peritoneal surgery. Like if you want to do totally extra peritoneal hernia surgery, or axillaroscopy, thyroid surgery, you can go up to 20 also. There is no problem. Because in extra peritoneal surgery, we are not pressing the diaphragm, we are not pressing the vena cava. If you want saphenous vein surgery in the groin or popliteal fossa, you may go up to 25. And sometime in the breast augmentation surgery, you have to lift the breast tissue from the pectoralis major fascia. You need a lot of pressure to get a space, you can make it to 30. So this is called as preset pressure. And this is, surgeon is giving command to the insufflator that you should keep pressure at this level. Insufflator will try to keep it at this level. So we are bringing it back to the our 15, which is a usual safety limit. That is 15, or better to go to the 12. Now this is actual pressure. Actual pressure doesn't have to take anything from the preset pressure. It will tell you the real truth. What is the pressure at the tip of this tube? Right now I am sucking it. It is minus. If I will push it, it is plus. If I will suck it, it was minus. And if I leave it, it is zero. So this will tell you the actual pressure. If it is attached with the venous needle, it will tell you the pressure at the tip of the venous needle. If it is attached with the cannula, it will tell you the pressure of the tip of the cannula inside the abdomen. So this is actual pressure. This is flow rate. Flow rate, normally with the venous needle we have to keep 1 liter per minute. This is set flow, liter per minute, which you will set yourself. And this is the actual flow rate. Even if you will put the 1 liter per minute, if this actual pressure will reach the preset pressure, flow will become 0. Remember, you can never adjust the flow rate of insufflator. You cannot force the insufflator to flow at certain liter per minute. You can only adjust maximum flow rate. So here maximum flow rate is 1. But how much flow should be there, insufflator will decide its own. and it depends upon how much is the demand. If there is no gas leak, this flow rate will become zero. If there is a gas leak at 0.5 liter per minute, flow will become 0.5 liter per minute. If gas leak is 1 liter per minute, actual flow will become 1 liter per minute. But if gas leak is 2 liter per minute, then also it will remain 1 liter per minute. Because set flow, maximum flow is 1. So only we can, set flow 1 means, doesn't mean that it always flow at 1 liter per minute. Means maximum flow rate will be 1 liter per minute. So this is called 1, 2, 3, 4 Quadro Manometric indicator. And this is total amount of gas leak. Right now zero, I have not started the flow. So now I am taking a varus needle and I will attach this varus needle with the tubing of the insufflator. Here we go and rotate, it attached. And after that you will start the flow. As soon as you start the flow, automatically insufflator will understand that I have attached the varus needle. And it is writing the varus insufflation. You see, it is written varus insufflation. And automatically insufflator will change the flow to the pulsatile mode. I will show you. See here. This is called as pulsatile mode. So it goes zzz, zzz, like that. Why? There are two reasons. One is that when it is off, then only it can sense the entire abdominal pressure. Because when gas flow, due to a small I resistance of the varus needle, it will feel the pressure of the flow. That will not be accurate. Just like when you go to fill up your tire air in your car, first they push some gas and then they attach the meter. And if it is less, again they push the gas, again they attach the meter. Because once it is flowing, at that time it cannot measure. So it is important that it should be intermittent to read the intra-abdominal. Because when insufflator is off, then it is sensing the intra-abdominal pressure. During flow, it will always sense the resistance of the small eye of the varus needle. So that's why it is pulsatile. Another reason is, company is saying that it wants to synchronize with the diaphragmatic movement. When diaphragm goes down, it stops, tends to stop. When diaphragm goes up, when we are expanding, it will push the. So there will be no vasovagal sound. So that's why most of the insufflator, microprocessor controlled, as soon as you attach, it becomes pulsatile. And let us assume that this is a abdominal cavity. This is gloves is abdomen, and I am putting it like that. And I am attaching the varus needle to start. And once you start, it is flowing. If you see it, 1 liter per minute. And it is distant. And this is now actual pressure is 2, then it will become. Once you release, alarm will stop. And again, it will give you 5 seconds time. So you can take this time to again meter. Again, alarm, again, stop. But suppose you don't know what this alarm is, and you ignore the alarm and keep on going in, what will happen? Injury, power injury. Why? Gas is withdrawn, abdominal wall is touching the viscera, and the heart has hit the viscera. So it is important to learn the alarms, what insufflator wants to tell you. And accordingly, you should come out and then go. This is important. Now, here this is why we have put to 6 liter per minute. This insufflator is 40 liters insufflator. But why we have kept 6 liter? Do you know if you have a sports car, it doesn't mean that you should drive at 400 km per hour. You will be killed. You should drive safely. So if it is a high capacity insufflator, you should turn it into low capacity. Do you know why? If more than 10 liters per minute for more than 10 minutes leak will be there, in extreme winter season, there is a chance of hypothermia. And there may be death due to hypothermia. You are doing surgery, you are busy in surgery, and doing surgery nicely, but one of the valve was defective. Gas was leaking. You forget to remove the reducer from one of the cannula. Cannula with the reducer, you remove the instrument, but reducer was there. And it is leaking at 40 liters per minute. And insufflator is pushing the 40 liters per minute. Abdomen is distended. Why distended? Because you have high capacity. And this rapid flow of the gas touching the splanchnic fluid and leaking out will create evaporation of the perineal fluid. And that will create cold blood in the splanchnic bed. This cold blood will go to portal vein, vena cava, ventricular fibrillation, and death. So always keep to the maximum 10 or better 6. So that if it is leaking more than 6, it will draw your attention. Oh no, why I have lost the cavity? You look for the insufflator and you will see that okay, it is 6 liter per minute, leak is there. And then you will remove the reducer. Close the valve. Take a bite over the skin. Or change the cannula. So this is safety. Just like a cruise control of your car. In the expensive car, there is electronic cruise control. Owner can control the cruise control of the car. If you can set to 60, and after that your driver will keep on pressing it, accelerator, car will never go more than 60. Because this is owner has fixed the cruise at 60. So this is, you should keep it at 6. It is safety. But suppose some accident happened or something wrong is happening. Suppose someone is coming to kidnap you from behind or to shoot you. Now you will not keep the cruise control on. You will immediately remove the cruise and tell the driver to save my life. Same way, suppose radial artery is bleeding, uterine artery started bleeding. Now you should turn it as a high capacity. Now this insufflator will give its power to you. But normally don't keep it fully charged. Now to 6 to, from 6, close up. To 6 to reach to 40, how many times I have to test it? 34 times, isn't it? 34 times pressing will take 34 seconds. By that time, bleeding will be more. But this insufflator is intelligent. So what you do? You do long press. And see, within 3 seconds it goes to 20 and after 3 seconds it goes to 40. Immediately it changed because it knew now. Insufflator will know that you are in trouble. Immediately it go 40 liter per minute. And now you do the suction, abdomen will not deflate. And you then keep on doing whatever. Once the bleeding stops, once the everything is fine, then again give long press. And it went to the, again, low flow. In some of the insufflator, manually, this type of adjustment is not there. They have three flows. Low flow, medium flow, high flow. So with the various reading, you should keep low flow. With the normal surgery, you should keep medium flow. During emergency, you should use high flow. But what does it mean, this high flow? High flow doesn't mean if I will keep to 40, it doesn't mean that it will start flowing at 40. It means if it is required, it can go up to 40. If you will open the cruise control of the car, car will automatically not start going at 400 km per hour. It depends upon traffic. If traffic is not there, car will be there only. it will not go. So this is important, and insufflator has to give the command. You will give the command, after that it will be okay. So this is the third pressure set flow. Now fourth quadro manometric indicator is total amount of gas used. Right now we can see the total amount of gas used, how much? 9 liters. Means since this insufflator was switched on, we have used the 9 liter gas. So far we have used 9 liter gas. If you will put a finger over that, it will be reset. It is reset. It becomes 0. Now it will count from now. Just like in the petrol pump, once one car is finished, they put press and it becomes reset to 0. Minimum amount of gas required to fill up the abdominal cavity is minimum amount of gas required to fill up the abdominal cavity is 1.5 liters. And maximum amount of gas required is 6 liters. In a normal adult, 1.5 liter for the small patient and 6 liter for very tall patient. So there are 5 variables. First variable is the size of the patient. Second variable, I must keep an eye that excessive leak of the gas should not happen. Total amount of gas is important. It is not good for you also. CO2 is a many a time not medical grade. It has a viral DNA, bacteria, carcinogenic, because once we do the surgery and when you use harmonic, the cytoplasm is breaking, tissue is fragmented, and once we take the gas out at the end, it has a viral DNA, bacteria, and some carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide impurities. So it is not good for your health to leak a lot of leak. So a lot of leak is bad for hospital. Hospital has to pay money for that. Bad for patient. Patient can go hypothermia. Patient can go dryness of the intestine. And bad for you because you are sick. So always control the total amount of gas used. Sometimes it has to increase. Like suppose you have a lot of bleeding, you are doing suction. Sometimes you are doing colorectal surgery, like total colectomy and all. Surgery may continue up to 6-7 hours. Then it is recommended that with irrigation, time to time, you should irrigate the intestine with the saline. Just like during laparotomy, how you are irrigating the intestine if it is outside. And that way you can prevent the problem. So this is about the quadro manometric indicators of the insufflator. Now I have few questions for you. These questions, themselves they will tell you how to read the insufflator. These are important questions. Question number 1. Reset pressure is 12. Actual pressure is 6. Flow rate is 1 liter per minute. Total amount of gas used is 12 liter. There is no distension in the abdomen in a 20-year-old lady which came for diagnostic laparoscopy for infertility. Where the gas is going? Again, I will repeat, reset pressure is 12, actual pressure is 6, flow rate is 1 liter per minute, total amount of gas is 12 liter. Do you know, tube leak may be one of the answer, but it is not. Why I will tell you? With the venous needle, which type of flow is there? Pulsatile flow? And pulsatile flow, what it is testing is, when it is not flowing, then it is testing the pressure. And if it is tube is leaking, that at that time it will feel the atmospheric pressure. And atmospheric pressure is what? Jesus. It is in the vena cava. Because vena cava pressure is 6 mm of mercury. Some people might have thought that it is in preparatory. But it is not in the preperitoneum. In preperitoneum, it can never take 12 liters. And still the pressure is 6. Is it possible? Is it possible to put a 12-liter container inside a 6-liter container? So abdominal cavity is a preformed cavity, Prepatonial cavity is an artificial cavity. So is it possible that you can put 12-liter in an artificial cavity and a still pressure is 6? It is not. But in vena cava, even if you will put 12-liter liter, as long as the flow is 1 liter per minute and pulsatile, patient will not die due to air inhalation. Because our circulatory system has the capacity to absorb the gas up to 1 liter per minute. Because CO2 is 200 times more absorbable than oxygen and 20 times more absorbable than human air. So it is in the vein. Second question. Present pressure is 12. Actual pressure is 12. Flow rate is 0.5 liter per minute. And total amount of gas use is 500 ml.
Pre-patonium.
Yes. This you are correct. This is pre-patonium. Pre-patonium is just like these gloves. Within 100 to 200 ml, it stretches. Fibrous trabeculae are breaking. So it is under tension. Because it was not a naturally present cavity. You are detaching it from the rest of the layer. And immediately preset pressure will reach to the actual pressure. But still little flow will be there. That's why the restricted 0.5 liter per minute flow is there. Maximum capacity of prepatonial space is 1 liter at 12 millimeters of mercury. More than 1 liter it will not take. It will say that enough is enough. Because patonium will touch the bottom. But if I will increase this to 24, it will take more because it is compressed now, isn't it? But at 12 millimeter of mercury pressure, prepatonial will take maximum 1 minute. After that, it will stop. Because pressure balance. Preset and actual come equal. So, flow stops. So, once you put variation in it, within few seconds, actual pressure reaches the preset pressure, that means you are in prepatonial. Now third second. Preset pressure 12. Actual pressure 12. Total amount of gas is 100 ml. And flow is 0. So unilateral distance. If it is a supra-pubic distance, that means?
Black.
Left side sigmoid colon. Right side cecum or small intestine. Epigastric is strong. Sometimes, before intubating anesthetist with the ambu bag, they put a lot of air into the stomach. The stomach may distend down. And especially if you are doing bariatric surgery or anything supra-umbilical, you may be in the stomach. So, NGT is must and it should be deflated. So, these are the variables. Now, question is, these are wrong settings. What is the correct setting? Correct setting is that you have to see the graph of actual pressure and total amount of gas used, which go parallel, always go parallel. Graph of actual pressure and total amount of gas used should not converge, should not diverge. Let us take one example. 18 year old, only 5 feet tall, a strong male who is going gym every day. This is size only 5 feet or less than. And muscular and young. He comes to you, as soon as he lie down on the table, you will understand that he will not take more than 1.5 liter. Because abdomen is tight, size is less, and he is male. So you start. Initially, within 100 to 200 ml, first thing what will happen? Liver done less, or urinate. After that, one pressure go to 3-4, one flow, total amount of gas go 3-4, pressure will be 3-4. Total amount of gas goes 6-7, pressure is 6-7. Total amount of gas is 1 liter, pressure is 10. Total amount of gas is 1.5 liter, pressure is 12. Graph is going parallel. But suppose initially 100 ml was okay, after that flow stopped. That means you are inductors. Now within 3-400 actually reach to preset. And still the flow is there, that means prepatonium. Isn't it? But actually, if it is correct in the abdomen, graph will be parallel. Now another example. A 70-year-old grand multi-para tall white female come to you, who has delivered 6-7 times. In her also 100 to 200 ml liver damage get augmented. That is always. But within 500-600 pressure will reach 0. Within 700-800 pressure will come 2-3. With a 2 liter pressure will come 5-6. With 3 liter it will come 8-9. With 4 liter 10-11. With 5 liter it will come to 12. And with 6 liter it will come to 15 or maybe 12 also, depending upon. So this graph is very important. That actual pressure and total amount of, this is such a beautiful machine. It doesn't take more than 5 second time to let you know where are you going. Suppose you are in preparatorium and immediately you see, oh, I have just 200 ml and actual pressure is reaching to preset pressure, immediately take it out and go again. Not wait. Don't let the gas make a huge preparatorial space. If you delay and already 1 liter preparatorial space is there, now next time again your pressure will go there only. No, it is lax and detached. Even if you do Hassan technique, it will go there only. This is important. Another important point is, even if you are using Hassan technique, initial flow rate should be 1 liter per minute. Sometimes we use high flow, abrupt increase in the intra-abdominal pressure can create vasovagal shock. So you should be slow in supplementation. Even in the Hassan technique. If you are using pediatric patient, then you have to change the mode. In the pediatric patient, you have to select for the pediatric mode. And pediatric mode, the rate of flow is 0.1 liter per minute per year of the age. 0.1 liter per minute per year of the age of the child. An insufflator automatically will go to 8 preset pressure. Here I am going pediatric. And see, it is 8. Set pressure is 8. Actual pressure is right now 0. And flow rate is 0.1 liter. If it is less than 1 year old child, if it is 2 year old child, 0.2. 3 year old, 0.3. 4 year old, 0.4. 5, 0.6, 0.7. And after 10 years, it is same as adults. So this is how the pediatric mode also can be adjusted. Even vessel harvesting mode, it will go preset pressure high, flow will be high. So this insufflator can prevent a lot of complication, and you need to learn it completely. But what are those meters? What they talk about? This is a gas cylinder icon. If it is fully colored, that means it is gas is fully full. Just like your mobile battery indicator. If it is half blue and half colored, that means it is half empty. And it will give you alarm also if it is going to be fully empty. Before 10 minutes, it gives you alarm that now refill the cylinder. And then many of the complications can be avoided. Now talk about cylinder. If you see the cylinder, when you buy the insufflator new, they give you cylinder 2 kg. That is sufficient enough to perform the surgery. You can perform one surgery. Sometime if you are leaking less, you may do the 2-3 surgeries. This is the cylinder 2 kg. And if you see on the back, it is attached this way. It should not never be like that. Otherwise, it is a compressed CO2, liquid CO2 enters inside. So always keep it erect. Even in the box of the insufflator in the back, if you will see here, they give it this way to attach. So that it will be a little bit inclined. It will not be lying horizontal. The tip should always be up. If you put upside down, liquid CO2 enters, that may spoil your insufflator. And